West Palm Beach, Fla Bethrood and Dawoodi, the art world doyen born into a New York real estate fortune, was walking through the Bunker Art Space, a renovated Art Deco building here that she recently opened as an exhibition space for her renowned and eccentric collection. Although just 2 miles from Mar-a-Lago, the building is another world, and an indication that this serene, largely residential area is making a play for some of the art scene pizzazz of Miami, just an hour or two drive south. This is the X-rated area, Ms. Dawoodi, a slim woman in her mid-60s, was saying downstairs in a corner gallery of the Bunker. Dressed in tropical fruit colors, and with her third husband, Firuz Zahidi, a photographer, and their small white poodle following, she passed a Paul McCarthy white silicone bust with a sex toy. A Nick Cave assemblage had one too. There was a painting depicting a crucifixion by George Kondo that might not be pleasing to some of her more conservative neighbors, and a deer's head made of zippered black leather, likely only to please a sadomasochist. Nearby, a doll-size sculpture by John Waters was having a play date with a Charles Manson doll. Ms. Dawoodi, who is president of the Rudin Family Foundations and on the boards of the Whitney Museum of American Art and the Hammer Museum, owns more than 10,000 pieces of art, including a vast array of work that is lyrical, artisanal, and playful. But she has a special fondness for the big button pushers that other collectors of her caliber might be more inclined to eschew. "I think art should be provocative," she said. The Bunker, which is open by appointment, is in a workaday area in West Palm Beach, across the intracoastal waterway from Palm Beach. Hers is not unlike the spaces of other collectors, including those of the Rubel family, Martin Margulies, and Rosa and Carlos de la Cruz, all in Miami and now open with regular visiting hours. But the Miami area, with its mammoth fair, satellite fairs, and myriad museums, including the newly reopened Base Museum and the Institute of Contemporary Art, is in a state of art overdrive. Until now, the Palm Beach metropolitan area, with only one art museum, the Norton, that sometimes shows contemporary work, has been mostly considered a city for safe and sedate exhibitions. Collectors here, including Republicans like the Commerce Secretary, Wilbur Ross, tend to have more recognizably blue-chip art. Contemporary galleries stick to the familiar too, catering to customers who have art advisors and decorating needs for winter homes. Along with Ms. Dawoodi, a few provocateurs are shaking things up. Sarah Gavlak has a contemporary gallery that doesn't shy away from selling sexually explicit and politically confrontational art on Worth Avenue, home to luxury stores and dealers offering soothing work by recognizable artists. A recent front-page article in the Palm Beach Daily News about Ms. Gavlak's organization of the city's first art weekend ran next to one about a local descendant of Pocahontas who is a Mar-a-Lago club member. Yvonne Force Villarreal, who helped found the Art Production Fund, a nonprofit that helps support risk-taking art around the world, was recently here to collaborate on a video and sound installation inside an abandoned West Palm Beach Macy's.